إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ويقول الله تعالى أيضا: يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا، إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم، إن الله عليم خبير. My dear brothers and sisters, today this Friday sermon is about human rights. I just want to highlight the human rights in Islam, so that human rights in Islam is in the beginning. This Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in these two ayahs which I have just mentioned. The first one, Allah says, يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة. Allah is saying to us, oh you mankind, oh human people, human being. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing in this verse all human being. So because Allah is the Rabbi, the creator of all everything on the face of the earth, under the earth, and in all the heavens. That Allah is not the Allah of Muslims only. It's not the Allah, it's not for a particular group. Allah is the Allah for all people. So in the Allah always talks to all mankind, mostly talks to all human beings, and specifically to the believers. That's why in the Quran, in many verses, you find Allah saying, Ya ayyuhan nasu, which means all you people, all you mankind. But in some verses, you find Ya ayyuhan ladhina amanu, all you who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you see these categories. The first category now is all mankind, all humanity. So humanity is the first. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifically tells special news to the believers. Allah says now, Ya ayyuhan nasu, oh you people, ittaqu, be dutiful, to be lawful, be conscious, and fear Rabbakum, your Lord. Be conscious and fear your Lord. This shows that we are human being, one entity. We are one group. So then Allah is giving us more details here. Ya ayyuhan nasu, oh you people, ittaqu rabbakum, fear your Lord. Why Allah uses here rabbakum? Rabb is the one who creates, maintains, sustains, feeds, takes care of them. So that is the Rabb, that Lord. You fear that Lord. Because He created خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. Why you be dutiful to that Lord? It is He خَلَقَكُمْ, He created you مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ, from a single soul. He created you from one soul. Here we say one soul, that means all of us came from one. خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا. And then He created the partner or the spouse of that life, He created out of it, that soul. So the one soul was there, and Allah splitted it into two. Took one out of the other and made them two. And those two are now, Allah is telling us, خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً. And He spread out many, many men and many, many women from the two souls, which previously were only one. So it was, the soul was only one. That's the human being. Then Allah made in the form of cloning the other one, took out his spouse from there, so that to accompany her, and so that they produce and they reproduce. Then Allah made them men and women, many, many men and women that you see, and they were on the face of the earth millions of years. So you look at this, that He created again men and women, so that to continue the reproduction of humanity, the human beings, so they increase, they become more and more. That's so that to maintain the human population. Then continuously Allah is saying, خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامِ. So fear your Lord, the one that in His name you ask about each other, and while you are referring to the rahim, the sa'aluna bihi wal arham, and also you ask each other, please give me this one, this one, in the face of Allah, in the name of Allah, you ask that person to help you, and again you ask the wal arham and the rahim. The rahim is the womb of the mother. The womb of the mother is the one that makes links between each two persons of human being. They came from the same mother and the same father. So you ask them in the name of Allah, and because the rahim that you share, that is rahim, the womb of the mother. That is a link, it's a robe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has these names, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. So you take that Rahman, it's a general mercy, and that mercy connects you to your Lord. It is one mercy, which is that is more general, and it's the one between you and Allah. And Rahim is the one between you and the people, and it's so special. So it is that specific one, specific mercy, which makes you the relationship between you and others. From there we can understand that you are always in two types of mercy. One is a vertical one, which is talk like this. The other one is a horizontal one that you share with the other people and with the nature. وَتَسَأَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامَ. So then you fear your Lord because of all that. And then the other verse which I recited above is was it tells that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is telling us, "Ya ayyuhan nas." Again, Allah is saying, "Oh people, oh mankind, oh human being." Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. We have created you from a female and a male. In dhakarin wa untha. So we created you from a male and female. Every person, originally our creation was that two souls, one male, one female. Again, everybody was created from one male and one female. And then Allah is saying, إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَىٰ وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ. And then we made you a shu'uban, peoples, nations, and qabaila, and also tribes. So we made you all that, we made you as people, or nations, and tribes. This shows you we are from one race. Because Allah did not use the term race, an ethnic, you can say it's tribe, but race is, they are one. So we can find that we are all one race. All the human beings are one race. So they are all of them are interconnected to each other and interrelated, and we are all the same. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلًا. And we made you peoples, nations, and tribes. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. But indeed, the one who is most honorable, the most well-respected one among you, is the one who fears Allah the most. The most conscious one to Allah is the one who is always higher than the other one who is under him. So our decrease depends on how we are close to Allah, is how we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then there's a question here, who can prove the one who is most conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The one who is more fearful of Allah? The one who is always pious, righteous one? Who can prove it? That is where the question mark is. And there's a trial in that, where you as individual, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing you whether you can be cheated by a general, what's called the rituals, the things that appears on top, that symbol, how that person dresses, how he looks like, how strong he is, and how he works that, then you can be influenced by that, and you may think this person, because he has this kind of dress, because he is originated from this particular clan or tribe and so on, and because he was born in that area, then he is more close to Allah than you. If you think like that, then you fail that test. It is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who knows the one who is the most righteous one. We can assume something, we can think, but it's not the final decision. We cannot clarify, we cannot make the decision to say this is the most right person. So then we have to be always in balance in that. In all that, what it shows is that we are all human beings. My point is that we are from one origin, we are one race. If you hear people saying this is race so and so, this is race and so, that's against human rights. Because we are all together one race. What makes that? What is the proof of that? It is scientific one. If we put even Islamic side aside, scientifically, if you look at the DNA. The DNA of all human beings is only one DNA. While animals, they have the they have different DNAs. And that's why now they do this type of colony to take DNA from one species of animal and take another one from another one, and they create that genetic, they make a different one comes out of them. Say for example, if you see a donkey and horse, if they come together and one of them produce another one, another race comes out of them. That race will be neither the horse nor the donkey, but a middle one comes there. So that is shows how their DNA is not the same. But all human beings, their DNA is the same. If two, one is black, one is white, come together, then that child may become the middle, but still the DNA, we are not talking about how they look like, but the DNA is the same one. The DNA shows both. And all that, what it, so that one testifies these verses of the Quran. It testifies the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he said, "Kullukum min Adam, wa Adam min turab." All of you are from Adam, and Adam was created from the earth. So all of us are from the earth, and we are from that origin of Adam. What all this shows to you? It shows that we are from one family, one person. Again, say one family. And what proof is that even logically? We have kept the Quran, the Hadith, and the science, and then come to logic now. Your logic is that if you are a real human being, if you see another human being who is even coming from a tribe that they were, that is rival to your tribe, and that person is in very critical situation, very bad things, then you feel sympathy. You feel as he or she is feeling. Because you see, if somebody is under torture and you are not related to that person by blood the way you think, you are related to that person, but the way you think, you don't think you are related to him, but you will feel some kind of mercy for that person. What it shows? It shows that we are from the same origin. So this shows you, if this person was, somebody hit this person, and you feel mercy, why do you hit? And you feel like that hitting is on your body. That means your body and his body are connected to each other. Your blood and his blood are connected to each other. So you are from one race, one DNA. That is the meaning of humanity, is that one tree. And again, there is satanic influence. If somebody is full of, is under the influence of Satan, that Satan tells to him, no, why do you feel mercy for that person? Forget it. He is not from your tribe. He doesn't look like you. This color is different from that, so and so. And then, if you see someone who has no mercy in his heart, that person is under the influence of Satan. And that person loses himself. Not even that one. Because Satan first tells you to hate someone. But again, he tells you to hate yourself. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says many verses in the Quran. وَمَا هُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ. They are doing everything within themselves. Allah says, they think that they are cheating others, but they are cheating themselves. Allah says, وَلَا تَخُونُوا إِلَّا أَنفُسَكُمْ. You are not cheating anything other than yourself. So the Shaitan, to kill you, within you, to kill you, he starts killing you and putting into your mind to kill others, then you kill yourself. Then all of them are gone. That person now went out of the humanity and went to the center of the shaitan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from that influence, which is very serious influence. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters, the issue of human rights, before we even come to the rights between two Muslims, the human rights is the basic one, and that we are all connected to each other. What shows you that we are connected to each other? We have talked, we picked up many reasons and many supporting evidences. But look at one verse of the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to us, وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقِسَاسِ حَيَاتٌ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. The qisas is it's to kill someone for because of the crime he or she committed. But that is also a life. Why? Because it is to save others from that person who is a murderer, who is so and so and so. Then, in order not to let that person continue and destroy many other people, it's to catch him. That is saving a life. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ قَتَلَ مُؤْمِنًا فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَى النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. Anyone who kills somebody is as if he has killed all the people, all the mankind. If you kill one person, that means you have killed all the people. And وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَى النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. And one who gives them life, not as you give them a life as Rabbi does, but you feed them. If you save that one person and feed them, that means you saved all humanity, all people. That is very clear evidence which you see how our body is connected to each other. But when someone is under the influence of Satan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already warned us from this in the Quran when he said, وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَعَانُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى. وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَعَانُ قَوْمٍ. Do not let yourself to be influenced by the shaitan to put you in hatred and enmity against someone. And that because you hate that person or that race or that tribe, then you are not making justice. When you see someone, you are witnessing, and your witness, you feel, why should I witness in favor of that person who is not even from my tribe, whom I hate him, and so on and so. So Allah is warning us from that, saying to us, do not let yourself to be influenced by the shaitan, to not to witness the truth because of hatred. So it is, if you are called for witness, and that witness is against your own brother, and the person who is the other part is your real enemy, then you have to tell the truth. It doesn't matter. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why is he telling to us this? Is that you don't know who is the closest to you. Maybe that one who is from another tribe will help you more than your own brother. And so you have to always look at the situation, is how you have to be careful and stay away from being influenced by shaitan. How to do that? Just to conclude, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Allah laid down many verses of the Quran that there's human rights. And that human rights is has a universal fundamental point. And those fundamental human rights are always based on what we can say. They're all in whole, in general, for all mankind. But also, it has specific ones. Allah give us the first six steps of human rights. We can say six fundamental human rights, which are an-nafs, wal-mal, wal-din, wal-irb, wal-nas. They are right to life, right to have property, right to believe, and right to have dignity, and right to have irb, to have genealogical relationship, a family, and a nation. So in all of that, Allah, those are the basic human rights. Maybe one in the coming khutbah Jum'at, we will pick up one of them one time and discuss about that in separate way. But now, let me conclude with one thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. That is all about morality. Allah, in order to maintain this human rights, Allah gave us many ways to protect the human rights. One of them is a legal aspect. The other one is morality, morally and legally. So morally is the one first leads us. If you lose the morality, then it's the legality which comes in place before that person destroys himself and others. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us to be always kind, even at war, even at peace situation. Whether you are in peace situation, whether you are in war situation, to have good morality in order to protect human rights. And that morality, it starts at individual level, family level, group level, nation level, and all universe. And it is always, there's collective right and also individual rights. And it is on all aspects of human life, be it economically, socially, politically, and all wise. So the time came, but brothers and sisters, make sure that you become one of the human beings who respects others, who takes care of others, who only follows Allah's way. And if you don't do that, then you will end up to the other side, which is the opposite. فَلَا أُوصِيكُمْ بِحَقِّ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَأُحَذِّرُكُمْ بِنَفْسِي وَنَفْسِكُمْ وَنَفْسِي مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ
اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ حَيَّ عَلَى الصَّلَاةِ حَيَّ عَلَى الصَّلَاةِ وَقَامَتِ الصَّلَاةُ وَقَامَتِ الصَّلَاةُ اللَّهُ